Zach, first off, congratulations on the new contract. Take us through what's gone on behind the scenes in the last couple of weeks leading up to this.
Yeah, thank you. You know, it was kind of quick, to be honest. I didn't really talk to them too much before the draft about extension or anything like that. Kind of just wanted to see their plans and what they were going to do. Obviously, I knew they had moves to make. And I was really happy with the moves they made. I think we brought in some great players. We drafted really well. And after that, we had some communication on Thursday morning. And then the contract went pretty quickly. It only took a few hours to get done. So I'm just really excited about it.
Zach, thanks so much for joining us. Congratulations on the deal. Really looks good on you. You know, once a player gets to your stage and you've kind of established yourself in the league, the critical concern becomes, what are my prospects for winning? Obviously, you see that in the Columbus organization. What specifically are you and management, what kind of discussions are you having about those plans that you referenced that give you the incentive, Columbus is the place for me?
Yeah, I mean, I think my big thing was just seeing what they were going to do. Obviously, I knew with Jonesy, you know, he, you know, wanted a trade or whatnot, or he was an unrestricted free agent. I wanted to see what they were going to do with him. I think getting Boquist and those picks was awesome. You know, they took Kent Johnson, who's a Michigan guy. I played at Michigan with the fifth pick, so I obviously like seeing that. I had great conversations with the coaching staff. So, yeah, and everything just started to excite me. And I love Columbus. You know, Columbus is a great town, and I want to be there. So it was a pretty easy conversation. Obviously, I knew I wanted to be there. And when we started talking about contract, it went pretty smoothly.
You know, Zach, there's been a lot of discussion about guys leaving Columbus. So I'm sure the fan base is thrilled that you're deciding to stay in Columbus, where, as you point out, they've brought in some young players and they've got some guys already in the system there. For this team to kind of make a quick turnaround back to being a very competitive group. Give us a little bit of the Chamber of Commerce about Columbus. I always enjoy my time when I come in there. I like it. It's a college town. It's a great arena, great facility. Sell Columbus to the fans out there who may not know enough about the city.
Yeah, it's an awesome city. I think it's very underrated. It's an easy way of life. Super nice, clean. You know, surrounding areas, great golf courses, which I'm a big golfer, so I like that. But yeah, no, I have a lot of fun there. There's great restaurants. There's good nightlife. And like I said, there's just a lot to love about Columbus, and I've got to experience it firsthand for 5 years, and I'm excited to be a part of it for longer.
Yeah, change of personnel behind the bench, Zach, as you transition, and really for you, throughout your tenure as a Blue Jacket, it's been a Tortorella regime. Talk about Brad Larson. What does he bring to the position? What are the positives that you view with a bit of a change behind the bench?
Yeah, I mean, I think change is always good. You know, sometimes getting a new voice in there can do wonders for a locker room and for a team. You know, I love Torts. I had a great relationship with him. And then obviously I have a great relationship with Brad Larson. We've had some good conversations lately. About where this team's headed and how he's going to coach, and I'm really excited to see what he can do. I don't really know the assistants too well yet. Excited to get to know them and meet them. I've heard great things. So yeah, like I said, I'm just really excited for this next chapter for Columbus hockey, and hopefully we can get this thing going in the right direction.
Zach, last year was obviously a tough year for a lot of reasons. It was a tough year in Columbus with some personnel issues that really became kind of a story onto themselves early on. How tough a season was it inside that room as you continued to move forward? Because it just seemed like there were a lot of distractions.
Yeah, I mean, that's nothing new in Columbus. I feel like there's always something going on there, whether it was Panarin and Bobrovsky or you know, something that happened last year or whatever. As players, you just kind of go to the rink and approach it the same way every day. Just go about your business and put the work in. Obviously, we fell short as a team last year of our goals of making the playoffs and trying to win a cup. You know, that happens. So now it's just resetting. Obviously, I think they've done a great job with the things they're doing this offseason. And I think everyone's excited just to get back to Columbus and have a bounce back year.
Zach, you got the contract buttoned down. It's really nothing but the remainder of the offseason to get ready for the coming season. Let the fans in on it. What's the summer look like for you? Where are you spending it? How are you working out? How are you training? When do you get back to Columbus to start up for the 21-22 campaign?
Yeah, I've been in Michigan all summer. I've done some traveling, gone to see, you know, family, cousins, and stuff like that early on. But lately, I've been here. Training's going really well. Started a new trainer out of Chicago, and it's been awesome. So I'm really excited to get there and get this season going. I feel really good on the ice. And like I said, we're going to get this thing going in the right direction in Columbus.
All right, Zach, you said it. We know you're a Michigan man. So the Wolverines had four of the first five draft picks in the most recent amateur draft, and your club drafted one of those young men. It's got to be a lot of pressure on the Wolverines and Mel Pearson in that group right now. What do you make of what's going to go on up there for the coming season? Because, boy, they're loaded with some good players.
Yeah, they're stacked. You know, it was unfortunate how their season ended last year, getting cut short with COVID. But yeah, that team they have up there, I love putting them on and watching them whenever I can. And they're just so exciting to watch. You know, obviously they probably have some pressure, but there's no better place than Michigan to play college hockey. So hopefully they just have some fun and go out there and play hockey. And obviously they should have a good season with the team they have.
Zach, you and EJ were talking a little bit about, you know, give us the Chamber of Commerce spiel. How do you sell the city? One of the challenges, I think, for the organization now is attracting free agents that can really help this group move the needle. As a player who has clearly made the decision, you've invested in this community, you're there long term. What do you say to other future potential free agents to sell the merits of the Blue Jackets organization going forward?
Yeah, I mean, I think the main thing is, you know, just how good ownership is, how good management is, how good, you know, we really have it in Columbus. I think unless you play there, you don't really know how good it is there. It's a great town, like I said. Ownership wants to win. We want to win as players. Management wants to win. And you know, like I said, it's just an easy way of life. You know, great fans. So, yeah, no, I'm all in on it. I love Columbus. I couldn't say enough good things about it. So, if any agent wants to call me, obviously I'll vouch for it.
All right, before I let you go, how's your golf game right now? You said you're a golf guy, so where are you shooting it right now?
Like high 70s. So I got the member at my club this weekend with my brother starting tomorrow, so we're all excited about that.
Yeah, should be good. A lot of fun. Good luck.
All right, yeah. Well, keep them on the fairway. Take care of the short game. You'll be fine.
I'll try.
Zach, thanks so much for the time today. We really appreciate it. Good luck going forward, and congratulations again on the new deal.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it, guys.